Hey guys, Cavecan here from the Mancave Effects. The past week, something awesome and something a bit less awesome happened. Awesome things first, I reached my 2000 subscribers. Now that's awesome. That's why this week's video actually is a double upload, as I want to dedicate this video to my subscribers and their comments, and the other one to the actual experiments and suggestions you have written in. Knowing that a lot of you don't like me talking too much and stuff, so I decided to make it just simply two videos, so you can decide if you want to watch your comments being read out or go on to the experiments right away. A bit less funny and nearly sad was NASA's announcement, if you have heard about that. Yeah, this little guy transmitted its last bundle of data end of last year, and since last week the unexpected 15-year-long mission officially has ended. Opportunity's last words, my batteries are low and it's getting dark. This is sad, man. So let's move on to your comments. Enough of sad messages. Or are they sad? We'll see. Absalom 7691, etching aluminum works better if you don't use tape and also if you don't use the cotton swab technique. I use spray paint, raster etch your pattern into the spray paint and then use a saltwater bath electrolysis. 12 volts at 3 amps only took about 5 minutes of just sitting in the salt water to get a 0.5 millimeter etch. Afterward, paint thinner or acetone will clean off the spray paint. The etch pattern is razor sharp and looks professional. Absalom, that's a nice idea. I will definitely try this out in the next video, like, which is already uploaded. You just wait until this video is finished, go to my channel, click on the next uploaded video after this one, and you will see this video with regular spray paint, engraving stuff in it, and then etching, do the actual etching by submerging the whole working piece into a salt water solution. Next one. We have Super Skag. What if you made a slurry out of powder coating powder and water or alcohol or other? Then coat the metal and allow to dry, then heat with the laser, then wash off the unmelted areas. It would be more permanent than paint and could also be resisting etching for etching. Powder coat can be removed with solvent and is very inexpensive. If it works, the process could be a replacement for screen printing on plaque or control panel lettering. Sounds like a good idea. The only issue I have, I don't want to brush on a powder coating mush onto a working piece because it will not be an even layer. It will not look as good. So, and I don't have access to a proper powder coating station. For now, the idea I think might work. I mean, you probably can burn off powder coating. Now, Danny Fisher, too much work for nothing. You better buy a label printer for around 50 to 80 bucks. And you can make labels without any laser cutter by yourself, especially for electrochemical etchings. Or go to and order some stencils by professional companies for less than a few dollars or euros. Well, Danny, it depends on what you want to do. When you have a shelf you want to put a label onto, you're better off with a label printer. But when you want to coat or you want to engrave a nice plaquette or something out of metal, you want to have it properly engraved. I saw one of those stencils you can use to etch onto metal, but this is not what we exactly or what I'm looking for. And well, paper labels are something completely different, and here is why. This won't work for my purposes. Michael Meinl, Just use regular spray paint for masking and then burn it off completely. Not just the outer lines, might need a few passes. Michael, that's exactly what I want to do. With the other suggestion, well, probably it adds up. It will be a mix out of both. So I will do your suggestion and then I will submerge the whole thing in some vinegar water and some salt water. We'll see what's better. Ben Ambleton. Wow, I haven't subscribed to anyone in a while. Super useful video. I've just ordered my K40. Hey, congratulations. I hope your machine works as nicely as mine does. Would like to see the homebrew metal spray video. Peace. Well, Ben, now first, if the K40 can engrave metal video, I was talking about a spray that is used for engraving things onto metal with a laser. It's based on some sort of a ceramic kind of powder or something, and you spray it on your working piece, you put it in your laser, you engrave onto it, and it burns somehow into the metal. Those sprays are enormously expensive. They're like 85 or 90 bucks a can. A lot of people are referring to a dry lubricant spray that contains molybdenum disulfate, and they state that this is actually the responsible or the active chemical in this stuff, and you can get other sprays, dry lubricants, that do kind of the same thing, and I think that's what you are referring to with the homebrew metal spray. What a coincidence, because I just received this today in my mail. That's exactly the stuff I was seeing in the video, and I don't know if it's radioactive or prohibited, but it's enormously hard to find over here in Europe. I finally ended up finding this stuff in Austria, and I just received it this morning, and I'm very looking forward to try out this stuff because I heard a lot of it about it, and it's supposed to work pretty good. On Amazon, where I tried to order it, and I believe you can order it from everywhere else in the world, there are several brands, and often in the comments you read about people asking if this is usable for laser cutters. It's a lubricant in the first place, but apparently a lot of people are referring this stuff for engraving onto metal. Looking forward to trying this out. Absolutely one of my favorite suggestions. And the next one is not about the laser, but it's about my abandoned TV station video I made a long time ago. It was one of my first uploads. And this comes from Stephen Gomez. European style binders and 220 volt receptacles, but everything in English. Wonder if it is an AFN station, but as that is military, they would have turned in the equipment and turned the building over to the host nation. I guess you could look at the expiration date of the box of cereals to get an idea of when the occupants were in. Stephen, well, first of all, AFN, for those who don't know, AFN is an Air Force broadcast TV station. Well, it's a whole network of military television stations around the world for the US. This particular TV station wasn't a AFN station, it was a European TV station, and I'm not allowed to talk that much about it, unfortunately, because what really is still a secret to me is that weird Google Street View camera contraption that I found in the cellar, because I knew that guy who was working exactly in that room at the time, and I never saw that camera or that mount, because it really looked like something you can mount onto a car and drive around with it. Maybe they used it for some sort of a TV commercial or something. I don't really know, but it's still a mystery for me as well until today. Okay, let's go on with the next one. Rabes. I wonder if you use the blue ink coating that is used when milling and set the laser to raster it off, then try the electrolyte method. I know that spray. It's a blue ink that you spray onto metal that is washable, but as it is an ink, it will not act as an insulator like paint. Alright, next one. Anur Akdak. How about Plastidip? Let us know if you can try to etch the Plastidip surface. I didn't know what Plastidip is. I made a little research on the internet. Plastidip is kind of a spray paint that is actually some sort of a sprayable rubber, which you can get in different colors. So you spray it onto something, and the nice thing is that you can just pull it off afterwards and it comes off like a skin. It sounds pretty interesting though, because it actually is made to get, you know, pulled off afterwards. The only thing is though, I think that when you cut it with your laser or when you engrave something on it, it might shrink a little because it is kind of a rubbery substance. I ordered a can of Plasti-Dip spray. I will absolutely include this into this double video. The other thing is that I found a Plasti-Dip which is transparent, which is even more interesting for, in my case, for my work, because okay, next one is from KC Oaks or KC0X or something. KC, editing is too much, man. Those sounds are annoying, not spooky. The flickering stuff is the same. Abundant Places are awesome with minimal extras. Well, you're right about that. By the way, this is again about the Abundant TV station video. The thing is, I really like annoying sounds. Marilyn. Am I the only one who thinks he sounds like Klaus from American Dad? But seriously, very creative, great job, you are very enjoyable. Thanks, Marilyn.
Do I sound like Klaus? I don't know.
1, 2, 3, Jero. Here is an English, here's an English lesson for you. 2, 2, 2, 3. That's as bad as I seen it. Well, Jero, thanks. You know, there are people in the world that apparently not natively speak English, and the thing is that I'm not German, I'm not French, I am Luxembourgish, and Luxembourg is a very tiny country squeezed in between Belgium, France and Germany, and we learn 5 languages in primary school. So sometimes it is pretty hard to switch languages very quickly, and sometimes it's hard to find the right verb in the right language at the right a certain point of time while I am doing things in front of a camera and have to take care of the lighting and everything. And yeah, so that's why my English sometimes sounds a little bit. Let's go ahead with the, oh, with the last one already. Okay, so ECV Duco or Duco, Duco says, been working with laser for a while now, try dental paste, the cheapest one. Do a couple of passes at 80% power, 3 at least, and it stick pretty good to metals. I found that the only way to remove it is using a file or a rough sandpaper. Try it. Cheers. ECV Duku. Another coincidence. I got some very cheap toothpaste, especially went out today buying this stuff. Now, when I remember correct, I was reading something about toothpaste, so that some companies put very small ceramic beads into toothpaste that act as a polish agent for your teeth. Maybe those might react with metal under high heat. Maybe, I don't know, but we are about to find out. As this was the last comment for today, I will take all this stuff now. I go over to my laser bench and I will start experimenting. As I said, the video is already online. Just go on my channel, click the next video that was uploaded after this one, and I will see you right there. And until then, see ya.